Hey folks, a quick video on embedding video and also sizing video in your pages or posts here. The thing about embedding third-party code is it can get kind of tricky, and you know, if you've been blogging for a while or if you've been creating pages in WordPress for a while, you know, it sometimes fights you. And I guess it's important to understand that it is the intention of WordPress to make adding content like videos more easy. So with the most recent upgrade here to 3.5.1, I thought I'd do a quick video to show you what's changed and where there are some user-friendly options. So here goes. First of all, let's go over to the Kinetic Knowledge Education channel on YouTube. Obviously, we're constantly putting new video, instructional videos here to help you guys with what you're doing. Recently, general video on what maybe you should be thinking about in terms of your web presence in 2013, how SEO is really going the wayside to content management, etc., etc. We did something recently on working with your media features in your dashboard. Forms management and troubleshooting obviously is important, the use of slugs, etc. But anyway, I digress. Let me choose a video that we can use for our example. I'm going to shut that off so that we can just get into it. I also have another tab here with an editor open, and I'm going to talk about that really quickly. With the upgrade, what you used to have is visual and HTML tabs. They renamed the HTML tab text. It is exactly the same as it always was. It's just been changed to text. I don't necessarily know why it was retitled text, but if it concerns you, it shouldn't. It's exactly the same. Let's start with our visual editor. And what I want to show you now with new videos is you can literally just take the URL of the video that you want to embed, go into your visual editor, and as long as it has its own line, meaning a space above, a space below, okay? And second, you do not link enable it, because if I hit enter right now, that would link enable this video, and I don't want to do that. So just make sure that it's not link enabled. You will be able to publish with video as is. And so let's take a look at our page. There you go. Now let's go back and just quickly look at what you might do if you wanted to size your video. Like for instance, I have a site here that has some site limit, some size limitations. In other words, the area for which a video could be added is really limited to this width. And so, in lieu of knowing exactly what that is, I'll show you how to play with it right now. Go back to your video. What you want to do is you want to find share beneath the video. You want to click that. It'll give you a share URL, but then you'll click embed, okay? And what you have is either custom size. If you knew the specific size dimensions that you wanted, you could just enter them, okay? And that'll change the code here that you're going to use. Or you can just choose from the drop-down, and they give you some pretty standard sizes. So let's say we're going to go with 560 by 315. What it does is it changed the numbers in the code here, okay? You're going to copy that code, okay? You're going to go back to your editor, and now you are going to go to the formerly titled HTML tab, now titled text tab. You're going to make sure that you give yourself a space, just like we had with the visual tab. Add that code, okay, and then update. And so let's view the page. And now I have a bigger video because I gave it a larger size, as you saw. So hopefully that helps. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to call. And good luck with it. Thanks.